main basic proportionality theorem. After 1.1, this theorem in examination, this is in basic theorem. So this short form is BPT. Statement is given in the question paper. You draw the figure given to prove and construction. This conditional statement in 9th standard. Statement is given. If a line parallel to a side of a triangle, means a line is parallel to one side of the triangle and intersect the remaining sides in two distinct points. Because three sides of the triangle, this line is parallel to one side and that line intersect remaining two sides in two distinct points. Then, after if given, and after then to prove, then the line divides the sides in the same proportion. That statement is given in the examination. So you draw the figure, triangle XYZ. This is construction, I write in the construction. This line AB is parallel to YJ. That is, and this line AB intersect XY in A and AJ in B. It is in the given. So given, in triangle XYZ, line AB parallel side YJ. Line AB intersect XY in A and XZ in B respectively, such that XAY between this X dash A dash Y and X dash B dash J. So this is like that to prove. What is prove? Then the line divides the sides in the same proportion. Means XA upon AY equal to XB upon BJ. It is the to prove. Construction. What is construction? Draw segment BY and segment AJ. So draw segment BY and segment AJ. Proof. Proof. You take the first pair XAB and ABY. These two triangles. Their bases XA and AY lies on the same line XY and they have common vertex B. If both the bases are lies on the same line and they have one common vertex, then their heights are equal. So that is statement. Triangle XAB and triangle BAY have a common vertex B. XAB and BAY have the common vertex B and their bases XA and AY lie on the same line XY. Therefore, they have equal heights. If height is equal, then we prove that. We write that property. If heights are equal, ratio of their area is equal to ratio of their corresponding bases. Therefore, they are equal heights. Therefore, area of triangle XAB upon area of triangle BAY equal to corresponding bases XA upon AY. Equation 1, triangles of equal heights. In reason that bracket, triangles of equal heights. Same, you take the pair XAB common. Like here, like second triangle, ABJ. So triangle XAB and triangle ABJ have the common vertex A and their bases XB and BJ lies on the same line XJ. Same set statement. Triangle XAB and triangle ABJ have a common vertex A and their bases XB and BJ lie on the same line XJ. Therefore, again same, they have equal heights. If equal heights, ratio of their area is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. So area of triangle XAB upon area of triangle ABJ equal to XB upon BJ. Equation second, triangles of equal heights. See equation 1 and 2, one triangle common. Here triangle XAB, here triangle XAB. If these two triangles are equal, BAY and ABJ, then this ratio are equal. So triangle BAY and ABJ, see that. BAY Y and A, B, Z. In previous one example, we can use that property. The lines on the parallel lines. So, if you draw the perpendicular from A and from B, their heights are same. Distance between the parallel lines and both have same base AB. So, base is same and height is equal. Therefore, ratio of that two triangles are equal. So, I write that statement. Triangle BAY and triangle ABZ lie between the same two parallel lines AB and YZ. Therefore, they have equal heights because distance between two parallel lines is same. So, equal heights. Also, they have same base AB. Base is same, height is equal. So, both are equal. Therefore, their areas are equal. Therefore, area of triangle BAY equal to area of triangle ABJ. Means if these denominators are equal, numerator is same. So this value, if 5 upon 3, then this value also 5 upon 3. So both the ratios are equal. Therefore, area of triangle XAB upon area of triangle BAY equal to area of triangle XAB upon area of triangle ABJ. Equation 3. From 1, 2 and 3, this side will be equal. Therefore, these two ratios are equal. Therefore, from 1, 2 and 3, x upon ay equal to xb upon bz. Hence the proof. Therefore, ratio are equal. You write one times again this. And again, through this theorem, write one, two times again on the rough page. So then you can remember that. Because this theorem in examination, basic